stay right here. We should lay right here. Cause everything is okay right here.
Hey guys, so today's video is going to be a Q&A, and I haven't done a Q&A in almost a month, so I figure it is time to do another one, and a lot of you guys really enjoy these. So yes, I'm going to answer some more questions that you guys have asked me, and a lot of you have been wondering what surgery I got, so I figured, hey, it's a Q&A. I'll tell you guys in this video. So the first question is from Karen, and she asked, what age did you begin to drive, and do you plan on traveling to other countries someday? So I actually took my permit test right when I turned 15 and a half, because here in Arizona you have to be 15 and 6 months to take the permit test, and I failed it. So I got so scared to take it again that I waited for an extremely long time to take the test again. I passed it, and then you have to wait 6 more months to take the driver's test. So I wanted to drive at 16 years old, but I didn't. As for traveling to other countries, I definitely want to travel the world someday. That's also kind of why I chose the career in the medical field, because it does pay a lot of money, and I want to have the money to, you know, travel the world and see different things. So yes, I want to travel everywhere, but my number one priority is going to either Japan or Germany. Adriana asked, what is your favorite band / music genre that you like to listen to? So, I mean, if you could kind of tell by the background of my room, I listen to a lot of 30 Seconds to Mars, Nirvana, Pink Floyd, the Rolling Stones, and I can't remember her name. I think it's Halsey something. I just discovered her on YouTube like a few hours ago, and I'm kind of digging her music right now. But yeah, I typically like more rockish kind of music, but sometimes I like to listen to Amy Winehouse and just miss her. Penelope asked, what is my favorite makeup brand? So my favorite makeup brand for foundation is definitely Estee Lauder. For like eye makeup, I really like Kat Von D, because her eyeliner actually stays on your eyes. As for lip products, I really like my J.Cat lip tars, which I just got a ton of them, so I'm gonna definitely do like a video showing you guys like all the colors. For my drugstore favorite, I would say it's probably Rimmel London or Maybelline. Sydney asked, if I'm going to dye my hair again, what color am I going to do next? Now, I need to really chill with dyeing my hair, because within the past like 6 months, it's been dyed red, purple, then bleached to blonde, and then dyed back to a 1B. Kind of letting it rest right now, but the next color I think I'm gonna do is probably red again. Like, once my hair grows out, I'm probably gonna just dye it back to that red color that I had about a year ago. And the question that a lot of you guys have been wondering, what surgery did I get? And some people were guessing that I got a boob job, some people were thinking that I got my lips injected, but I already said this in the last video, my lips are real. And someone also commented on a haul that my butt looked bigger, that I probably got my butt done. No, I just work out now. I actually, the doctors, and this is something common in my family, so I hope I don't scare anybody, but it's common in my family for your lymph nodes to get inflamed like around this area. So one of them became inflamed, so my doctor wanted to go in there and see what it was, and they ended up finding 2 balls of meat. One of them, I guess, was this big, and one was like that big. So they said that they were glad they took them out, because if they wouldn't have, it might have turned into something really bad. But don't worry, you guys, I am fine. But yeah, that's pretty much what I got my whole surgery thing on, because breast cancer does run in my family, so it's something that we kind of watch really, really carefully within like the girls in the family. So I just wanted to get those things removed just in case, I don't know, it could have possibly turned into something, I don't know. Sammy Glam asked, do you talk about your relationships with your siblings, and would you expect it back? No, I do not talk about my relationships with my brother, just because that's kind of awkward. My brother is about to be 15 years old, so I mean, it's like weird, like I don't have anything to tell him about my relationships. I usually go to my mom or my friends about that kind of stuff. But as for what I expected back, yes, I expect my brother to tell me what's going on in his life. Like, my mom always threatens my brother, saying Jaden, don't bring some ratchet home because Vanessa's gonna scare her away and call her ratchet. So I expect my brother to keep me, you know, notified with what's going on in his life because he's my baby brother. Doko asked, why don't you ever wear your hair curly? I always say this, I can't. You guys, like, I can't. Like, I physically cannot wear my hair curly because my hair's not curly anymore. I don't know what happened, but after dyeing my hair so much, my curl pattern literally disappeared. When I wash my hair and if I wake up in the morning, my hair will be straight slash wavy and be a little bit kinky at the top, but I can't wear my hair curly anymore because it's literally not curly anymore. And that's what happens when you damage your hair so much. Girls, don't do it. Let those natural curls live. So somebody asked me what I would do if I hit 1 million subscribers, and I've already answered this and I'm gonna keep saying this until I hit 1 million subscribers. When I hit 1 million, I'm going to buy a big cake and I'm going to jump into it. Like, I'm serious, I'm going to jump into a giant cake to celebrate. I'm not gonna be those YouTubers who just, you know, post a picture on Instagram holding a balloon that says 1 million on it. Like, no, I'm going to literally jump into a giant cake like Katy Perry did. Emily Grace asked, have you always had a passion for beauty and fashion? No. When I was really young, I literally didn't know what to do with myself. I have photos of me in the most ugliest outfits. One day I'm gonna show you guys, like, one day, I think probably, hopefully this happens once I get to like 500,000 subscribers, hopefully. I will definitely do a looking at old photos video and show you guys how ratchet I looked. I matched the most weirdest items together, yet I thought I had swag. So no, I have not always been into fashion and beauty. I barely got into like makeup and stuff when I was like 15 or 16, and then I barely got into trying to dress myself correctly like last year. A lot of people want me to do the brother tag. I'm not gonna do the brother tag until I'm at least 100,000 subscribers. Why? Because it's not something you can do more than once. So I want to wait until I hit like a milestone on my channel, and then I'll do that video, just like I said, with like the showing embarrassing photos or that kind of stuff, because you could only do those kinds of videos once. Like, I can't do my brother tag more than once. I have one brother and, you know, things aren't going to change all of a sudden. Stella asked, if Dave Franco was in the middle of the ocean drowning, would you go and save him? I remember you saying you don't like open water. Baby, I'm about to dive in. You best believe I will dive into that water. I will go to the end of the pier and jump into said open water and save my boo. I know I've said it before, I hate open water and I can't even go into the ocean up to my knees because I'm afraid a shark or a boogie monster is going to drag me underneath, but he's bae. So yes, I would dive into that ocean and save him. Several people have asked me what color contacts I wear, so I thought I'd show you guys. These are the Fresh Look color blends in the color green. And when I wear my blue contacts, they are from Pinky Paradise. Opinion on Kylie and Tyga. So many people have asked me to make like a story time or like a girl talk, Nessa talk on Kylie and Tyga. But honestly, I am in no place to talk about their relationship. Yes, she is 17 years old and he's what, like 25 or 26. It's obviously illegal for them to be together, but they're celebrities. What else are we gonna say about it? If it was, you know, like real life, like say I was 17 and a 27-year-old was trying to get at me and my parents got mad, yeah, the cops would arrest him, but because they're celebrities, they can do whatever they want. They can get away with whatever if they have money. So yeah. Rebecca said, baby, your channel is growing so fast. What are you doing? I don't know. I honestly, like, my mom even told me this. She's like, dang, you just hit 70,000. You're already at 73,000. Like, what's happening on your channel? And I said, I don't know, mom. People like me now. A lot of people keep asking me, like, how do you earn subscribers? How do you get subscribers? How do you get subscribers? People are always Snapchatting me that, asking me to, like, give them tips on how to get subscribers. But honestly, I don't know. Like, I just make videos of people today. There's not a technique on how to get subscribers. I mean, if you have a decent quality camera, your room's not extremely messy, Wait, mine is actually, so scratch that out. If you are funny or you have a good personality, then people will want to watch you, I guess. And you don't have to, you know, go out in public and film a ton of videos or do DIY videos and just do all the stuff that a lot of other YouTubers are doing. If people like you, they're gonna stay on your channel because, I mean, look at Jenna Marbles. She films like all of her stuff in her like house, apartment, wherever she lives, and she's just sitting on her bed and she has millions of subscribers. Just like there are some YouTubers who, you know, do the most and, you know, do extravagant videos and then they have millions of subscribers. You just gotta do what you're good at. And what I'm good at being is a thought. And the last question I'm gonna answer is from Halen Tania. If you had to quit YouTube, what would your backup job be and how about that Dave Franco edit? So let me talk about the Dave Franco edit first. You guys, so many of you always send me edits of me and Dave Franco next to each other. Like, someone sent one of him like standing next to me and he was this short and I got so sad. Actually, two different people sent those and I got so sad because he was like here. I love them, you guys. Like, I love when I get these edits. So if you want to send me an edit of me and Dave Franco, do it, honey, and I will give you a shout out. As for my backup job, I'm in college and I'm going to become an anesthesiologist, so that's my job in the future. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope I answered some questions that you were curious about. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. I love you. Subscribe to become a member of the Franco family. Thank you everyone for 70,000 subscribers. And I'll see you all in my next, ow, I cracked my neck. I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys. Mwah.